case we shortly go through most of the ECGs and there are and MI and all other causes for ST elevation. Here we can see that there is a normal axis with a QS in V1, V2, V3, V4, but there is no Q and there is a small R with a huge ST elevation and also TA being upright. So most probably ongoing ischemia is there in the V5, V6 territory, but there is already a sort of much of the dead myocardium and slight, you can see that there is slight QRS prolongation in V1, V2. So it's most probably the interwall MI with there is inversion of 2-3 AVF being seen, slight elevation in AVL. Most probably it's a LAD territory being proximal, just proximal to the septal and distal to the diagonal, or maybe proximal to diagonal also, depending on the angiographical correlation we can see. So this is the angiographical correlation. There is a proximal LAD infraction, but just distal to the first diagonal. So most probably this is the diagonal which was making the patient really comfortable, otherwise you would have the severe pain. So this is the similar ECG. You can see that there is slight AVR elevation is there. Also we can see that there is slurring of the QRS. This is with slight LVBB and QS complex being formed, and there is no much problem in the V5, V6 or else in the lateral leads and inferior leads. Most probably it is septal or distal most LAD being infected. The distal most anterior and septal, most probably distal to the septal and diagonal. So most probably the distal LAD being infected, so not causing much of the harm to the major of the myocardium. So this is one of the classic of the inferior wall MIs I have discussed already. There is a huge ST elevation of the 2-3 AVF, 3 more than 2, and there is a reciprocal changes in the V1, V2, V3, V1 not being classic of the ST elevation being seen. V2, V3 are showing the depressions, lead 1 and AVL is also showing depression, so it's most probably the RCA which is being getting affected. So here is the same angio, the proximal RCA being affected. There is a huge hyperdominant RCA, so depicting posterior wall, inferior wall and slight lateral wall ischemia. Okay, this is a picture of pure lateral wall MI, either diagonal or the obtuse marginal branch, the non-dominant L6 being territory being infected or infected. V2, V3 shows slight ST depression. Always look for reciprocal changes in some or the other leads. If there are no reciprocal changes in any of the leads, most probably you are not dealing with a big heart attack, or most probably you are not dealing with a heart attack only. You are dealing with something else like HOCM or Brugada syndrome or the other variants of the early depolarization syndromes and all, hyperkalemia. So if you are getting a reciprocal changes like this is a classic reciprocal change. There is a huge pure ST depression with TVA being upright. This is a reciprocal change, and even in AVF, even in AVL, and if you can see lead 1 in upstairs, there will be ST depression. So it will be depicting like there is a reciprocal change, and V5, V6, V6 actually shows a good amount of ST elevation. So most probably it is either occupying a non-dominant circumference or a diagonal branch. So here you can see that the sac is being occluded and is open. So always look for the reciprocal changes, it's very important. So ST segment morphology is being shown. The various phases of STEMI, you should know that QS with ST elevation, small narrow QRS, actually the ST being elevated, not yet elevated. So actually you can see the QRS compressed correctly, so ST is being elevated. This is hyperacute ST elevation. Same ST elevation with getting aneurysmal elevation, same ST elevations. So this is very important. You can see in pericarditis that there will be PR segment depression with a concave upwards ST elevation. There will be a left bundle branch block, the bundle exit blocks, or there will be LV aneurysm, a deep QRS with a persistent ST elevations. There may be